हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू अवर यूट्यूब चैनल सर्वाइवल ऑफ द फिटेस्ट। टुडेज टॉपिक इज अबाउट डिफरेंस बिटवीन अपोप्टोसिस एंड नेक्रोसिस। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ अपोप्टोसिस एंड नेक्रोसिस एंड व्हाट इज द रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ दीज टू प्रोसेसेस। सो दिस टॉपिक इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर ऑल लाइफ साइंसेज रिलेटेड एग्जाम एंड नॉट ओनली फॉर रिटन एग्जाम, इट ऑल्सो इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर PhD इंटरव्यू। सो लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट डज मीन अबाउट अपोप्टोसिस? So in this video we will discuss about what stimulation are required for apoptosis and necrosis and any cell when get enter into the apoptosis and necrosis, what type of morphological and physiological changes will occur, and after that when apoptosis and necrosis get completed, so what is the fate of those cells which complete the apoptosis and necrosis. And during apoptosis, lots of enzymes are involved, which is known as caspases. So what is the role of caspases enzyme? And some techniques are available for identification of apoptosis and necrosis, and some markers are also available. So in this video series, we discuss all these things. In this video, only we discuss about difference between apoptosis and necrosis. So let's get started. First of all, what is apoptosis? Apoptosis is a programmed cell death, means it's a controlled cell death. So only one cell participate in the process, means it's a suicidal process, pre-planned cell death. So only one cell get decided to enter into the apoptosis, or only one cell get know about the about apoptosis. So only one cell know that I will enter into the apoptosis, no any neighboring cell get affected, okay. And in necrosis, it is an accidental cell death, means any injury, any accident get occurred, an accidental cell death. So it's an uncontrolled cell death, or group of cells are involved in this process. So group of cells are involved in the necrosis, and first difference is only one cell. Here is only one cell are involved, or here is group of cell are involved. And second difference is what is the requirement of these two processes. So first of all, we need to understand what is the requirement. So for maintenance of cells, like lots of cell maintained by cell death, like replaced by new cells, and old cell get enter into the apoptosis. So for maintaining of tissue balance and for cell stress like starvation condition, and pathogen infected cells like any virus or bacteria when get infect any cell, so we have to eliminate these cells, so we protect our neighboring cell. So these cell get eliminated by the apoptosis. And during developmental processes, like we all know, during developmental process our digit get attached to each other, okay. So like that our digit get attached to each other, so we have to separate these digits. So for separation of these digits, apoptosis play an important role, okay. So separation of digits, apoptosis, and after that some frog development. For frog development, metamorphosis play an important role. So during metamorphosis, tadpole larva get convert into the adult form. So in this conversion, some tissue and some cells are present in tadpole, which get eliminated by the apoptosis. And these cells, like these organs like tail and tail cells and external gill cells, so these cells get eliminated by the apoptosis. So during developmental processes, this apoptosis process play an important role. And after that, some aging and self renovation process, like some cell like blood cells and skin cells get replaced by the new cell, and these old cell get eliminated by the apoptosis. And during DNA damage, some DNA damage, some checkpoints like ATM and ATR get activated, and these checkpoints activate the P53 gene. So this P53 gene activate the apoptosis pathway. So during any defect in cell mechanism and cell DNA damage and DNA defect, so those cells get eliminated by the apoptosis. And any transformed cells like cancerous cells and tumor cells get eliminated by the apoptosis, because these cancer cell through metastasis get invade to other tissue also. So we have to eliminate this cancer cell, or for elimination of cancer cell, here apoptosis play an important role. And during cancerous cell initiation, some markers are available, like phosphatidyl serine is flipped outside to the membrane. So here during apoptosis, flippase get inactivated. An ATP dependent process, but necrosis is energy independent process. Here ATP does not required. And after that, what morphological changes will occur during apoptosis and necrosis? So first change is chromatin condensation. Normally in our cell, our genetic material remain in chromatin form and thread form. So and here some proteins play an important role for attachment of these chromatin to nuclear wall and nuclear membrane. So during apoptosis, this protein is known as lamin protein, and these lamin protein get degraded during apoptosis, and this nuclear wall is also get degraded. So these chromatin get in condensed form, like in prophase phase, these chromatin get condensed. And after that, some changes like cell get shrinked like that. And some blebbings are also formed to the cell membrane. So cell membrane get blebbed, and these blebbings rejoined and form some specific bodies, which is known as apoptotic body. So these apoptotic body will form. So here membrane integrity is maintained, and membrane blebbing will occur, and these blebs get joined each other and form apoptotic bodies. And these apoptotic bodies get engulfed by the neighboring cells. Okay, so this is about apoptosis. And during necrosis, like trauma condition, any toxic stress, any acute injury, any lack of blood supply, so these conditions will stimulate the necrosis. And this is the energy independent process, as we already discussed. And after that, some changes occur during necrosis, like chromatin clumping. Here chromatin get clumped, and cell organelles and cell get swollen, means cell get swelled out, or cell organelles also cell swelled out. And after, when cell gets swelled, so its chances to burst out the cell, so cell get bursting out, and cell content will release to the cytosol and outer side, so another cell get also affected. Okay, and here cell membrane integrity does not maintain, because cell content is released to the outside. And so an inflammation also occur in during the necrosis. So these are changes will occur during necrosis, and these changes are occur during the apoptosis. So here main difference is apoptotic body formation, but in necrosis no any apoptotic body formation. Here membrane integrity is maintained, here membrane integrity does not maintain. Here cell will get shrinked out, but here cell get swelled out. ओके एंड हियर सम स्पेसिफिक एंजाइम्स आर ऑल्सो इन्वॉल्व विच इज नोन एज कैस्पेसिस एंजाइम एंड बट हियर ड्यूरिंग नेक्रोसिस नो एनी कैस्पेसिस आर इन्वॉल्व बट लाइसोसोमल हाइड्रोलाइटिक एंजाइम्स आर ऑल्सो इन्वॉल्व इन द हाइड्रोलाइटिक एंजाइम आर इन्वॉल्व इन द नेक्रोसिस. So this is the main difference between apoptosis and necrosis. And after that, in next video we will discuss about what is the caspases and what is the role of caspases during apoptosis and what is the different type of pathways are involved in the apoptosis. So what is the extrinsic pathway and what is the intrinsic pathway? Because apoptosis get activated by the two type of mechanism. One is extrinsic means outer side and one is the intrinsic pathway. So any outer molecule get activate the cell for apoptosis and any internal material get activate the cell for apoptosis. So this is the main difference between apoptosis and necrosis. So I hope you like this video. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please hit the like button and share this video to your friend and subscribe to my channel. So I will see you in my next. Till then, take care. Bye bye.